Hello guys, today I invite you into the world of the crawl and ball with all the regressions. So we start on the knees. I take my tennis ball and I just want to pass it from one hand to the other hand. Just like that, I want to connect the brain with the hand-eye coordination. Then I can tap it, change the pace. Now, as you can see, I'm shifting the body weight back, so I have less weight on the upper body, and then I can shift the weight forward to make it more intense. Just like that. Now it's knees off, way more intense. I'm on all four now, only 4 points of support, and I pass the ball from one hand to the other, keeping a good form, straight back. Next up is to go forward and backwards. So this is the foot and crawl and ball. Every step I make, I combine the foot and crawl technique with juggling with one tennis ball. It takes a lot of coordination and focus. Now I do the crawl and dribble. I want to bounce this ball on the ground, and I start knees on the ground first to decrease the intensity. And then when I'm ready for it, knees off the ground, same thing. I try to do a couple of those on the left hand, then on the right hand. Mix it up. Just like that. Mix up right, left. Yeah, see, I'm going faster now. Change the pace for more stimulus. And I try to also move forward and backwards. So from static to dynamic. We always want to dominate the static before we go dynamic. Now what I want to do is a warm up going from prone to supine position, because I will now do the inverted crawl and ball. So from the bent seat position, same thing, I pass the ball around. Just want to get used to this movement with less intensity. Now I post 3 points of support, 2 feet, one hand, and I pass the ball from one to the other every time I change the hand position on the ground. Now let's see if I can go with the forward position, the forward movement, the backward movement. Takes a lot of coordination and a lot of focus. And this is what we need. We need to live in the moment. I switch the object now. I get a bigger one, a bigger ball. And this is more for the strength aspect. The ball is heavier, so every time I have to, you know, display more strength. Don't spin the ball like I did. Try to keep the ball steady. Just like that. And see, I change the pace again. Knees off the ground now after the regression. Let's go. I stay in place, but I keep bouncing the ball. Takes a lot of strength now to be able to do it. And as always, I want to go dynamic now by moving forward and backwards. Keeping the contralateral pattern of my crawling. And keeping the ball from going from one hand to the other hand. Now I'm trying with the football, but this time from the inverted crawl position. Same regression as always, less intensity, but on the ground. Now, but off the ground, 3 points of support, one ball, passing from left to right, over and over. Right now I don't move, I just want to be used to this passing along. And now let's go forward and backwards. Let's go for it. We are ready. We have a good coordination. We know how to do an inverted crawl and we know how to pass the ball along. So we try to combine skills. It's called skill to skill training. Just like that. Okay, now this is the most challenging part. I want to do foot crawl and ball, but balancing on a 2x4 beam. This is very, very challenging. Every step is like a big effort in balancing and coordination. That's the last level, guys. I hope you enjoy this. Try this at home now. Let's go.